Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today I want to discuss the topic of importing and exporting your contacts. Let's go. You might be wondering, why do I need to import or export contacts? Well, there could be a variety of reasons. Maybe you want to share contacts with someone else. Maybe you want to add contacts to a different email service. You might be moving from iCloud to Gmail, from Gmail to Yahoo, from Yahoo to AOL, from AOL to Outlook. Regardless, when you import and export contacts, it gives you the ability to save your contacts from one location and put them in another location without having to retype all of them. I see this most when someone may have an Apple ID that's kind of shared amongst family members, and so they have a whole bunch of iCloud contacts, or they have a whole bunch of Gmail contacts, and now they go off and create their own account, but all of the contacts are over here, and they don't know how to get the contacts over here. So importing and exporting contacts, let's dive in. Let's start on the Mac. If I go to contacts here, we'll continue off with the good old Samsung family and tech giants. So in my iCloud, I have all of these contacts, and I have Bart and Homer and Lisa and Maggie. And then I also have this tech giants group, which have Microsoft, Apple, Google, all of that. But we're just gonna stick with the Samsung family because I actually have some information in there associated with those contacts. So if I go to all iCloud, I can export these contacts out in a variety of ways. One of the easiest ways, honestly, is just selecting all of the contacts. I can select all of them, or I can go up to edit and choose select all. And I could easily drag this to the desktop. And just like that, those contacts are exported. I could also go up to the file menu and do export and export it as a vCard. You also have an option to do a contact archive, but honestly, you'll probably never use that because it puts it in a very specific format that other Google Outlook is not going to be able to read. The most common formats are vCard and CSV for comma separated value. If I went up to file, export, did export vCard, I could say others, I'll just say all contacts. And you'll notice that once I click save here, it's gonna be the same as this other option over here. So really they're identical in the file format and all of that. So that's how we export them out. If we wanted to import them in, we just reverse the process. If I go to file, I can choose import. I can select all contacts or the Bart Samson one. And if I do open, it's actually going to bring them in and it'll actually recognize duplicates. It's going to say, hey, there's duplicates here. And I could say, well, let's review them. And it gives me the option to either keep the old, keep the new, keep both of them, or update the old one with the new information. And if you ever have duplicates, you can always go up to card and say, look for duplicates. And it's going to analyze and say, hey, there's 11 duplicate cards. And we can actually merge them together. And then I'm back to square one with those. Now the other option here too is because I have my other accounts inside of the contacts here, if we go up to contacts, choose accounts, it's gonna bring me over to system preferences. And I can actually see that I have contacts turned on for Gmail, contacts turned on for Yahoo, AOL, Comcast, no contacts. So don't use Comcast, it's just not a good email system. But long story short, I actually have these other contacts associated with these accounts in my address book or in my contacts also, but there's nothing in them. Because I have contacts selected under Exchange, which is Microsoft, I could drag this in there and it's going to import and add these five contacts to this Exchange account. So if I actually go out to Safari and I go to my Outlook here, let's refresh, these contacts will start to show up because I just imported them and it's got to synchronize from the computer to Microsoft Outlook. So I refresh and here they are. So now I have all of those contacts associated in there. Now let's go over to Google. So I have my Google contacts here and notice there's no contacts here at all. And if I go back to my contacts on my computer, if I go to Google, which is my Gmail, notice there's no contacts here. So I could drag this file into there, but let's do it a different way. Let's actually go out to Google here, and there's this import contacts because I don't have any. You'll also find import here on the left-hand side. And if I click on import, it's going to say, hey, to import contacts, select a CSV file or a vCard file. So I'm going to select the file because I have it on my desktop. So I can go to my desktop, do all contacts, say choose for upload, and then import. And now it's going to bring in those contacts into my Google ecosystem, into my Google account, and that I've just imported them all here. Google has a really nice feature for finding duplicates also. It'll say, hey, we just imported some new ones. Do you want to find the duplicates? And it doesn't really find any because there's not any, but it is kind of nice. So now if I go back to contacts here, all of those contacts are now in Google. If I go back to contacts on my Mac, it's going to take a moment for it to synchronize, and then it will sync from google.com, from Gmail, and it's going to sync back down to my computer in the Contacts app. Now, all along while we've been doing this, if I go into the contacts on my phone or my iPad, I can touch groups in the top left. Let's uncheck iCloud, and now we just have all Outlook selected. So notice here are those accounts just showing in Outlook. If I uncheck Outlook, I'm not going to see any contacts because I'm not telling it to show any. If I touch all Gmail, and there they are. So they're already showing up in my Gmail. If I touch all Outlook, I'm going to see them again, and all iCloud. Keep in mind, it merges them together. So for example, if I touch Bart here, notice down at the bottom, linked contacts, because it's saying, hey, this contact also exists in Outlook, it also exists in iCloud and Gmail. So that's why it actually doesn't show up as duplicates on my iPhone or iPad, because it actually links them. It's smart enough to do that. But just know, it's very important to know where your contacts are at, and this is a way to do that. And if I were to uncheck all of these and touch Yahoo, notice there's no contacts there because I haven't imported and I haven't created any contacts in Yahoo. So if I wanted to do that, we could go out to Yahoo and, or actually let's go to Google. Let's export out of Google. And it's as simple as going to export here. And it says, what do you want to export? Do you want to export particular labels or groups or all my contacts? I'm going to say all. And this is where it gives you options to either export as a Google CSV, an Outlook CSV, or a vCard. Typically, any of them will work. It's gotten to the point where a lot of these accounts are very universal and pretty friendly with the file type. But we'll stick with the Google CSV and see what happens. So we're going to export that out, and it goes into my downloads. So we're just going to drag that over here to my desktop. And a CSV is nothing more than a spreadsheet. If I do a quick look at this, it's really just a spreadsheet that has that information associated with those contacts. So now let's go to Yahoo, and we're going to go to contacts in the top right here. And there's three little dots here, and we can say import from another account. And this is where it'll actually give me options to import it directly from another account here. So AOL, Outlook, Gmail, Yahoo. And so actually, if I were to choose Gmail, it's going to prompt me to log in with Gmail. And then it's going to send me a code so that I can verify that it's me. So I'll get a text message here. We can type in that code, 721-867, next. And yep, we'll allow. And now it's going to import those contacts. You know, every account is slightly different. I notice here there's no option to actually upload a file. It only links with an account. So if I was purely using iCloud, I would have a hard time getting my contacts into Yahoo because they don't actually offer an option for importing a file. Let's go back. See, all of these ads, how, I don't understand. Ah. So in Yahoo, here they are, the contacts imported, they linked it with Google, and now they're there. Let's try AOL here. If I go to AOL, we'll go to Inbox, and down in the bottom left, we can go to Contacts, open Full Contacts, and under Full Contacts, we have an import and export option, so we're going to do import, and notice here, browse for file, it wants a specific CSV file. So that vCard file most likely won't work, but let's go ahead and try it. Let's try it. We'll do all contacts, choose for upload, we'll do import. And so notice no contacts came in because it really wants that CSV file. So if we go back to more, choose import, we're gonna choose that CSV file, choose for upload, we'll do import. If you have AOL or Yahoo or any of those, These advertisements on the right here just are terrible. How do you live with that? I just don't understand. All right, so I tried both importing into AOL and it doesn't like any of the files. So this is yet another reason, don't use AOL, just don't. The last thing is iCloud. If I go out to iCloud here, we can choose contacts, and here are those contacts. So I have my groups on the left, I have my tech giants, and down here in the bottom left, we have this little gear that allows me to either import or export a vCard. So it doesn't necessarily want a CSV card, a CSV file, it wants those specific vCards. And this is where I could say import, and it's gonna prompt me to say, okay, where are we importing from? I'll do all contacts, choose for upload, bring those into my iCloud account, and now they show up, which it did create duplicates because iCloud itself does not recognize it. But if I go back to contacts on my computer here, go to all iCloud, notice they are duplicated. I can just go up to card, say look for duplicates. It's gonna find the duplicates. And I can also merge cards that have the same name but contain different information if I want to. So I can say merge, and then it's gonna squeeze those back together, and now I'm back to square one. So I have now my contacts in iCloud, I have my contacts in Outlook Exchange, I have my contacts in Gmail, I have my contacts in Yahoo. So that's pretty much how you import, export, various reasons of why to import and export contacts around from one account to another. And by doing that, know that some accounts don't allow you to synchronize between devices. So if I go to System Preferences on my computer and I go to Internet Accounts, notice some of these accounts don't allow me to synchronize certain information. For example, Comcast. Comcast only synchronizes mail and notes, nothing else. No calendars, no contacts, nothing. AOL, It gives me options for mail, contacts, calendars, notes, reminders. But notice Gmail, Google, does not do reminders. It does mail, contacts, calendars, and notes, but no reminders. So some of these accounts allow you to synchronize, some of them don't. So just be aware. That's another reason why some people prefer to use Gmail over AOL or iCloud over Comcast. And same thing on your iPad or iPhone. If I go into the settings, I can go under accounts and I can actually see what these accounts are capable of syncing. If I go to accounts here, I can look at iCloud. And if I go to iCloud, notice I can synchronize all of this different content. There's so much that iCloud intertwines with because a lot of it is part of Apple's ecosystem. If I go back to accounts and choose Outlook, notice I have mail, contacts, calendars, and reminders. Outlook doesn't do notes either. Look at that. If I go to Gmail, I have mail, contacts, calendars, and notes. If I go to Yahoo does mail, contacts, calendars, reminders, and notes. AOL only does mail and notes. So if I had all of my contacts inside of AOL, I couldn't get them on my iPad or iPhone very easily because it doesn't synchronize with it. If I go to Comcast, again, mail notes, but Comcast doesn't even work. I spent like an hour trying to just get my old account on here. Not even worth it. So just don't use Comcast. So overall, that is importing and exporting contacts in various different accounts and how to move them between one place and another. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something. If you did, hit that subscribe button, tap that little bell, and we'll see you next time.